Today, we're going to look at two ways to get high-end skin softening in Photoshop. Both methods are not complicated and they'll save you a lot of time. We'll use Photoshop's neural filters for the quickest and easiest way first, then we'll use the median and high-pass filters for a more flexible method. I'm going to start off with a quick and easy way first. We're going to use something that's fairly new to Photoshop. It's called neural filters. So I'm going to duplicate my layer and come up here to filter, neural filters. Now, if you haven't used neural filters before in Photoshop, I highly suggest that you take a look at them and see what you like. I have a link in the description on neural filters and you can check that out. So we're going to select something up here called skin smoothing, and notice that the model here has a square that is around her face. Photoshop neural filter skin smoothing is looking for a face. I've selected skin smoothing and I'm going to click right here on this button, and we already have some skin smoothing. If you come down here and click, it says show original. You can do before and after, and you can see it's already done a fairly good job. But if you want more smoothing, depending on the complexion you're working on, you can increase your blur and smoothness all the way up, and then come down to the output box down here and select current layer and say okay. At this point, you can look at the subject's face, and if you need more skin smoothing, you can come up to filter, and the very top menu item says neural filters, and that's the last thing you did in Photoshop, the neural filters. So you can apply the effect again just by selecting this top menu item or using the shortcut. So if I select it again, it applied more skin smoothing, but we don't need that much. I just wanted to show you what it does, so I'm going to hit Command Z. And so you may not want to apply this to all the skin areas. So what you can do, you can add a black layer mask, come down to the bottom of the layer panel, hit Alt or Option, and add layer mask. Now you can get your brush tool, B for the brush tool. I usually paint with opacity 100, and I have a low flow. I'm going to say 3, and I'm going to make sure that my hardness is all the way to 0. So I'm using a soft round brush. I'll make my brush a little bit bigger with my right bracket. I'll hit D, and that will make sure that I am painting with my foreground color of white. I have my layer mask selected. I'm zoomed in here a little bit, and so I can paint in, just select areas where I think it needs softening. So that way you don't over apply it, all that softening that we have here available to us at once. And you can take your time and just apply the softening where you want. And this method is quick, and it is really good if you're just trying to apply softening to the face only. Remember, in this case, Photoshop just recognizes the face. You have control of applying as much smoothness as you want. So this way it still looks natural. It's not overdone. So there's the before and there's the after. Photoshop did a pretty good job of applying that filter. It hasn't taken away a lot of highlights or shadows. And if you want, you can go further. A good thing to do at this point is you might want to add a curves adjustment and do dodge and burning. So I'll add one curves adjustment, make it very light, and invert the layer mask, call this dodge. And then I'll create another curves adjustment layer, make this very dark, invert the layer mask, call this burn. And so then you can use your brush tool, make sure that you're painting with white, hit D and X so that the foreground color is white, whichever you want to start with. Say highlight the burn layer mask, and you can paint in more shadow here on the cheek or any of the darker areas using a low flow. You can see that already. And you can do the same thing, dodge, paint with white, maybe in some of the highlight areas that you want to enhance. I'm painting on a very low flow, and I can group these two layers together holding shift and clicking on each of the layers, saying Command G to group that, call my group D and B. And of course, if I think I've gone too far with both of those, I can lower the opacity a little bit on the group. If I think I've added too much softening, I can lower the opacity there too, just to keep it all realistic and natural looking and not overdone. So that's the first method of skin softening, using the skin softening neural filters and dodge and burn. Here is the before and here's the after. Do me a favor, hit that like button. It really helps the channel. appreciate it. Second method that is more flexible has a few steps that we need to go through to set it up. So first we're going to duplicate the background layer twice. And this top layer, we're going to name it details. And the first thing we're going to do is we're going to desaturate that layer. So it's Command Shift U or Control Shift U. And we're going to right click on that layer and convert it to a smart object. And I'm going to click on the layer below it and call it color. And we're going to convert that to a smart object also. I'm going to turn off the detail layer and select color layer. And we're going to apply a filter. So I'm going to come up to filter, noise, median. Now these filters that we're applying are the areas that are going to be flexible. We're going to be able to go back to these filters and change them to help us get the amount of smoothing that we want. I'm going to zoom in here a little bit. I'm going to click on the skin and I'm going to increase the radius until I see a good amount of the blemishes gone. I'm going to say, 25, 26 right there. And I'm going to say, okay. Now remember, we're going to be able to go back to these filters and change the values. So now I'm going to make the details layer visible and select it and come up here to filter other high pass. And I'll bring that all the way down to zero and bring up the radius maybe to 2.5 just so I start to see detail and say, okay. Now I'm going to change the blend mode of the details layer to linear light. Now I'm going to select both my detail and my color layers. Hit Command G to put them in a group. And with that group selected, I'm going to make a black layer mask. Hit Alt or Option and hit the Add Layer Mask. And now, just like the other method, we're going to paint in our skin softening. So select your brush tool or hit B for the brush tool. My opacity is at 100, my flow is 3%, and I have a soft round brush. And with my group layer mask selected, I am painting in the areas where I want the skin softening. And you can see that I have my skin texture, but I am smoothing and the softening effect is not overly done. I can paint in any of the areas that I want to apply the softening. So I'm going to go through the image and apply it where I feel I want. I have a low flow, so I'm really applying it on most of the image. I'm building it up slowly so that it doesn't look overly done. And with this method too, I can paint different areas of the body and get some of that skin softening. Skin texture is still there on that group. I can lower my opacity a little bit. And just like the other method, I'm going to use dodge and burn. I'm going to create two curves adjustment layers, one for dodging. Bring up my curves very bright, select the layer mask and invert it. Command I, this will be my dodge. Create another curves adjustment layer, make this dark, invert the layer mask. Command I, it's my burn. And I like to group them together. Hold shift and select each of the layers. Say Command G. Now I can select, say, my dodge layer mask. Make sure I'm painting with a white foreground. My flow is low. And I can just paint in a little bit of highlights there. Not too much. You see that I just add a little bit of highlights. And as a suggestion, you can add a black and white adjustment layer on top of everything and decrease the reds and the yellows. So this will put some contrast in the image so that you can see where you want to dodge and burn a little bit better. And this way you can see any of your highlights a lot easier wherever they fall on your subject. And you can work like this and add your highlights and you can add your dodge and burn that way. And then when you're done, you just turn off your black and white adjustment layer. So that's just a little tip while you're dodging and burning. Here is the before and here is the after. In my dodge and burn group here, just call it D and B. And I can also change the opacity on that so I can control that way. I can come down here to my group where I have my smoothing on my details. I can click on this arrow over here and I can see my high pass smart filter. I can click on that. I can adjust my radius if I need to. On my color layer, click on this arrow. Here's my median. I can also adjust my radius. So this method has a lot more flexibility and you have a lot more control over your details and your dodge and burn. This method, you can also add some smoothing to other areas of the body. So here is the before and here's the after. If you want more in-depth tutorials on skin retouching, click on the playlist on the screen now. If you haven't already, like, share, and subscribe. And remember, it's never too late to learn. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.